Hello everyone, in this lecture we will be discussing the concept of conditional GANs, which we abbreviate in short as C-GANs also. So what is this conditional GAN? So what advantage this will offer as compared to normal GANs? So we will discuss in this lecture about this. So let's see what advantages this conditional GAN has as compared to the original GANs. So let's discuss that. As you might have seen my earlier lecture on GAN, then you must have seen this output of our GAN executed on Google Colab. So what do you observe from this output? The one important thing that you observe on this output is that there is no control on the type of images that are generated over here. By saying on control means we have this MNIST data set, which is the MNIST fashion data set. In this MNIST fashion data set, we have 10 different categories which consist of shoes, shirts, pants. So there are 10 different categories. But here you see when you generate through GAN, you are getting all the categories, all different type of categories. Sometimes it happens that shoe is not there. You can see there is no shoe, but there are other categories. So you don't have any control on the outputs. So that is the basic drawback of GAN. That is, you don't have the control on the output which GAN is producing. So if we want to control the outputs of the GAN, that is, if I wish to show only shoes in all these grids, or if I want to show only shirts in all these grids, so how to change the code so that it produces the output the way we want? That's the theory of conditional GANs. So as you might recall, that a typical generative adversarial network has the following objective function to be achieved. But what you see over here is that there is no extra input that we can control. So what we do now is, in order to improve this GAN further, what we do is we insert a condition of labels into this objective function. So by inserting a condition of label into this function, what we are obtaining is this. As you can see, now the probability is conditioned on y, which is the labels. And similarly here also, the probability that is being generated by the generator is also conditioned on y. So we have inserted the label information. By label I mean to say that if this is the fashion data set, we have these labels y0, 1, 2, 3 up to 9. So we are inserting this information, that is the label information, in this probability. As earlier, there was no such information available about the labels. By inserting the label, we can generate the output as per our control. That is, if we want to generate shoes, we will generate different varieties of shoes. If we want to generate shirt, then we will generate only different varieties of shirt. Or if we want to generate bag, then we will generate a variety of bags. And it's not that we will be generating bags, shoes or shirts together in single space, as in case of GAN, as you can see over here also. So just to avoid this situation, we are putting a condition also now. So this objective function is basically the objective function of conditional GAN, which we will try to achieve. And please note that all the derivations that we have done or understanding that we have done for GAN will be applicable to C-GAN also. The only difference is that now it will be a conditional probability instead of single probability, that is dx. So now it will be conditioned on y, that is dx over y. So this is basically a simple representation of the C-GAN. And you can see over here that how the inputs along with the labels are fed into the discriminator. This discriminator already has single layer network that we will be implementing in Google Colab, along with only single output. So we have only one output over here, not this one. So it's only single node output at the discriminator, because we are generating only 0 or 1. So the output of this, because of the insertion of this label, is not dx now. It will be dx conditioned on y. That is the difference. In earlier case it was only dx, but now it is dx conditioned on y. And the third input that is coming is through the generator. And in the generator also, you see we have one hidden layer which is given over here, and this is the output node which is of size same as that of the image, that is this one. And the inputs to this generator are the noise distribution, that is z, along with the label y. So that is the difference. So now the output of this generator will be g of z given y, not g of z. And when it is fed into this discriminator, it will produce the output d of g of z given y and not d of g of z, which was in the case of GANs. So this is basically the typical flow of conditional GAN, which has an advantage over normal GANs. So now we will implement this conditional GAN in Google Colab. Okay, so now we have discussed about the theory of conditional generative adversarial networks, and we have discussed how to incorporate the label information into this GAN network. So let's see how we can implement the same in Google Colab. As indicated earlier also, that the conditional generative adversarial networks or C-GAN are not totally different from generative adversarial networks. There is a slight modification in terms of the input that is fed into this, additional input that is fed into this C-GAN. Otherwise, the whole architecture is nearly same as that of GAN. So this is basically an extension of generative adversarial network code. So I will not go into too much detail of each of these lines because this is already discussed in DL_32 lecture, which is basically a complete detailed analysis of generative adversarial networks in Google Colab. So here I will discuss only the major differences which makes conditional generative adversarial networks different from generative adversarial networks. So this is basically the same part as was there in DL_32. So let's run this. This is also the same. So it's downloading the data set. This is just creating the folder. This is copying the content and reading the data. This is just for your information. I'm printing out the test and train data set along with test and train labels. So you can see we have 10 different classes over here. And we have 55,000 training samples and 10,000 test samples. But as you know that there's no need of testing images here because since it's a generative network, so we will only focus our interest on training samples. So this is just plotting of the data. This I am not running because it's same as it was in earlier case. So let's leave that. This is also the same, with the only difference is over here where you have this y_dimension, which is the label dimension, which is 10. So we are feeding this information also now. So let's run this. Now we have to define weight and bias dictionaries. This is also the same as in case of generative adversarial networks, but a slight difference over here where the input to the discriminator is there. You know, when the input to the discriminator, we are adding a y_dimension also along with this, because here we have this concatenation of the input in the sense that we have input data along with the labels. So that's why we are adding the two together. And similarly for the generator input also, we have this y dimension appearing in addition to the noise input which we will feed into the generator network, and y_dimension is added to this because it's an information of the label that we are also feeding into the generator. So that's why we are adding this dimension also. So let's run this. Now we are defining the placeholders. This placeholder is the extra placeholder that we are defining, and which is basically the placeholder for the labels that we will feed in from outside. Otherwise, the z_input and x_input were labels which were earlier also present. Now comes the discriminator section where we are having a modified input, which is in the terms of tf.concatenate x is equal to 1 value x comma y. So what we are doing here is we are feeding two values x and y, and these x and y will be concatenated in horizontal direction. So x is basically the image size and y is basically the labels. So labels will be concatenated with image. As you know that the image is having 786 dimension and y is 10 dimension. So the total will come out to be 796 dimensions in the horizontal direction. So this is basically the modified input which will be fed into the discriminator over here. Earlier it was only x. Now it is x along with labels. Similarly, same thing will apply to generator also. We will be feeding the modified input to the generator over here. So once this is done, you can see I am calling this generator function by inputting it noise along with the labels. And similarly for the discriminator section, we will be inputting x original inputs along with their labels and the noisy inputs which are coming from the generator that is here along with labels. So these label informations are attached to the inputs that we are feeding from outside. So let's run this, and this is same loss as we have discussed earlier also. So let's, and this is the second loss which you can run yourself also. So let's do one thing. Now we will run this type of loss. In the earlier lecture, I ran this loss, but in this lecture, I will run this loss so that to show that both losses are working perfectly. So let's run this loss now. So this is basically the same as we have discussed in our GAN lecture also, that is DL underscore 32. And now you see here, this is basically the initialization of the variables and running the session. In running the session, what you can see is we are feeding extra label information also, like this over here, and the same label information over here also. In a similar way, in the discriminator also, we are attaching the label information here as well as here. In earlier case, this y underscore label was not there in all these four inputs. Otherwise, everything else in this code is same as that of generative adversarial network code discussed in DL underscore 32. So let's run this. So this is basically running the code, and you can see we are having generator loss and discriminator loss given as 0.15 and 2.79. So let's wait for the whole execution to stop. So as you can see now, the C-GAN is optimized in terms of generator loss and discriminator loss, and we have completed 98,000 steps, and you can see that the loss is oscillating between 2 and 1 for the generator loss, whereas for the discriminator loss it is oscillating between 0.9 and 1, something like that. Once our C-GAN is trained, so let's execute this code. This is just for plotting the results, so we will execute it first. Now the important part is, as we have discussed, that since it's a conditional GAN, we will put condition on the generative adversarial network to produce specific outputs. So we know from the database that 10 different categories in fashion data set, some are t-shirts, some are trousers, pullovers, dress, coat, sandals, shirts, sneakers, bag and ankle boots, all these are labeled from 0 to 9. So now here we will plot only 16 samples of a specific category. So that's why I am writing it here as sample is equal to 16. Now we are creating the noise, because in the generator, once the GAN is trained, we will feed in the noise, right? So we will sample noise from the uniform distribution between minus 1 to 1, and its size will be, that is, it will have 16 samples of 10 dimensions. Since we need 16 images at the output, so that's why samples are 16 over here. And the dimension that is fed that is to be fed into the generator is z underscore noise dimension, that is 100. So now the important part comes is we have to feed along with this the labels also. So in order to create a label of our choice, we are writing this line of code which creates one hot vector of this labels. One hot vector is created by typing np.0, and it will produce a zeros of dimension 16 cross 10. So it will be a matrix of 16 rows and 10 columns. And we want one for the category that we want to output. If we want shirt to be displayed at the output, then what will happen is this one hot vector will produce one at the position 6, and the rest will be 0. And if we want to produce bags at the output, then command will put 1 at the 8th location and the rest will be 0. So it's a one hot encoding of the categories that we have written over here. So now what we will do is we will do sess.run onto the generator network by feeding it noise along with the label that we want to display at the output. This is basically the function that generates samples. And this generate plot is basically this one. This is used for displaying purpose. So let's run this. This is executed. So now the important part is this. Here you can see we are calling this function create, and in this create we are calling specific category quote to be displayed. Not all these categories are to be displayed, but only quote has to be displayed. So let's execute this and see what will happen. So now you can see only quotes are displayed. They are of same categories. And it's not that all the 9 categories are displayed. So let's do one thing. Let's display ankle boot and see whether the boot is coming or not. So let's run this. So you can see all different categories of boots are displayed. So this actually helps in putting the condition on generative adversarial networks that to produce only specific category of the output and not all the categories.
And here you can find, and here you can see the log file is also created. And if you wish, you can download and see in Tensor Board how this generator and discriminator plots are plotted. So this shows that even this particular cost function is also working. That is, this particular loss function is also working, which we have not shown in our earlier lecture, which was DL_32. So this completes the concept of conditional generative adversarial networks. Thanks for watching my lecture. See you next time.